What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's been a while since the last video, but here we are. Today we're gonna try this tool. It's been sent to me to test it. It's called King Bolen. It's an OBDII device. It should work on any car. So let's go ahead, let's try this. But first thing first, intro. Contacted from this company if I'd like to try this new device, so I say why not. Let's go ahead, try this out. The name is YA100. It's a OBDII device. This you can check car codes, you can scan it, you can see if there are any problem with it, you can clear codes. It's pretty much a complete device. It does a lot of things. But let's go ahead, let's go unpack it, let's see what it comes with box. So there is a quick start guide. You can more or less understand how the device works. It looks pretty straightforward to me. So let's see. It's got a... got a fairly long cord. This plugs directly in your OBDII port in your car. I'm gonna show you in a second where this is located. In every car, more or less is the same place in every car, but I'm gonna show you in a moment. The device is pretty light. Looks pretty simple, just four buttons on it. So up, down, back, and okay. So yeah, looks pretty easy. Let's get to the car, let's plug it on, and let's see what we can do with it. Before getting to the car, this is time to ask you if you can consider to subscribe to the car, to the channel. A lot of videos are coming out, all of course car related. In this there is my trip from England to Portugal with my X1, so we're gonna talk about this, how was the experience and everything. After that, please click on that notification bell, you're gonna get notified so we can check together the new content. Everything's been said, let's go to the car. Isn't she a beauty? So if you don't know where the OBDII port is located, it's always in the driver's side, about the footer. In my case is right here, you can see it says OBDII. There are some other brands that they keep it right under the steering wheel, right on the way on the bottom, but more or less it's always in this area. So anyway, let's open it up. See, exactly like that. So we just plug it in, that's it. The device has already lightened up, let's see. So you can see there are a few options. The diagnostic, trouble code, lookup, voltage test option, about, let's see what we can do here. Option, language. Yeah, there are quite a few languages. There are quite a few languages, so whatever. Unit, metric or English, that's okay. Data login, self test. So it appears that you can test the device, display test. So yeah. Everything looks fine. Let's see the keyboard test. So up, down, okay, back, all okay. Let's go back. Okay, we saw this, but anyway, let's turn on the car. This device requires for you to turn on the car. Ah, yeah, I got a new Android unit. It's gonna be a whole separate video. I went back to the original head unit. This is plugged internally with the aux cable, but we're gonna talk about this another time. So let's do voltage test just to understand. It's at 12.2. It's kind of fine. Let's turn it on. Let's see what's happened. Yeah, it goes up to 14, so everything looks okay. Let's see. So if you have a trouble code on your car already, you can actually check it here, for what they understand. Or you go in DTC lookup, it's for the trouble codes. So you choose brand of your car. This case is a BMW. You have code PBU whatever. With OK you go forward. You can change this and then you can look up the code. What we're gonna actually do, it's a diagnostic. Let's see. There are, for what they say, no trouble codes. Read codes, stored codes, no code stored, pending, no pending, permanent, nothing like that. You can erase the codes here. Yep. So also there are live data. Let's see what it say. Oh wow, there is a lot of stuff here. Oh wow, ICT, IMAP, RPM. Let's see if I love it. Yeah, that's cool. It's working nicely. Oh yeah, there is a lot of data you can go through. Oh wow, that's a lot. There's really a lot of data you can go through. Seriously, you can spend some time here and check out your car. Monitor, okay. Read codes, stored codes, nothing. Pending, nothing. So, there is freeze frame. This it helps if you have something to get checked, so you can freeze it and check it later. Vehicle info. Turn the key on with the engine off. Let's see. you can see your vein. Oh wow, nice, that's very nice. It's got really a lot of diagnostic you can do with this. And then in this case I don't have any trouble codes, but if something comes up, you can definitely look them up, and if you're not satisfied with it, you can also look them on the Google. So you just write down the code on the Google, but this is gonna give you a fairly description to it, so I believe this is gonna be fine for you. So yeah, this pretty much, that's it. So I'm wondering, so monitor, okay, monitor NA8, AG anti-spark, okay, read code stored. So this car is pretty much okay. Yeah, that's very cool. So yeah, I'll say this device is after all not that bad. It's very simple to use, it's very straightforward. There is a diagnostic, trouble codes look up, you can have live data, you can voltage and all that stuff, you can change language, whatever you like. Yeah, it's pretty much that's it. The device is not that expensive itself. I'm gonna drop you a link down in the description, and I'm able to give you also what is called a discount code, so that when you're gonna buy, you write down the discount code. This should be a link for Amazon. So yeah, the without discount code is, I think, about 25 pounds, 25 euros, something like that. With the discount is gonna be even less. So it's cheap, easy to use. There is some time to spend on it. I mean, there is a lot of data to go through, so you can check your stuff. And yeah, pretty much that's it. This is time to ask you not to forget to subscribe to the channel. As I said, lots of videos are coming up, so guys, let's stay tuned. See you next time. Bye.